And I must say, I was really amazed how in such a short time you could arrange such a nice program and such nice music. Especially the music surprised me very much. I've never had such good poetry and such good music from the French. This time it was really remarkable. Why I have called you to talk to you, because I've had no time to talk to the French separately. I thought I better talk to you here. And you are so many. I'm very happy to see that. I must tell you that France has been the most difficult country for me to work out surgery. To begin with, we had Marie, who was in charge of the France Sahaja Yoga. And somehow or other, she found it impossible to manage things. When I came for lectures, there were so many people. But when I went away, they all attacked her very much. So every third month, she used to telephone to me, "Mother, you come along, otherwise I'm going to give up Sahaja Yoga. I'm not going to work with them." Whenever I came here, they always used to tell me against her, "She's like this, she's like that." And to such an extent that I told them, "Have you any replacement?" She was a very generous person. She had given her own house where I used to come and stay with her. And between me and her, we would pay for the hall, for all the arrangements, for advertisement. She paid part of the money. Of course, I did pay, but she paid part of the money. But the criticism was so much that I could not understand that instead of going into Sahaja Yoga, learning about Sahaja Yoga, they were just criticizing her. That was their job. And she had a friend. I mean, she was a real good friend of hers. She also started misbehaving. So the person who was criticizing her was Alexander, very, very much. So I told that, "All right, you become now the leader." Though Mari was a very deep person and was a real seeker and very truthful person. And she was very generous. And she never asked people for anything. But small, small things they would ask her, like, "Where did you spend this money? Who has done this?" Like, I mean, it was terrible, as if they were supporting her, you see. And I reached the conclusion that we have to change the leader. So I got Alexander, because he was very critical of her. And then Alexander started staying here with his wife, who was Indian. But he was much worse.
Hello.
He started making money here. He bought a car out of that money, did all those things. No complaints for him, no complaints. Nobody complained, nobody told me that he was making money like this, nothing of that. Nobody criticized him either. The father-in-law of this, he came here and stayed with him.
So,
and he is an Indian. He came and told me that, "Mother, I'm really shocked. This Alexander is a cheat." And all the 5-6 who are living with him had joined hands with him.
His
wife also, she doesn't know what to do, but she has confessed to me. I didn't know what to do. I said, "Where is Sahaja Yoga and where is this horrible leader?" He used to send me a big bill every time I visited this place. He got a hall which was for £1,000 per night. For 2 nights he got it, and I had to pay that money. My husband used to joke that other gurus make money here, my wife is sending money from. I told him that, "You see, this is only for France. I'll have to work out, because I'm worried about French people and I must work it out, so you please don't mind." Then when I talked to Alexander about it, he said, "I'll have to send back my wife, because now I can't afford her without being the leader." I said, "Don't threaten me. If you want to send her, you send her away. I'm not going to be threatened by these things."
Okay.
And in Sahaja Yoga, nothing is hidden, nothing is kept secret. But I didn't want to expose him or to talk against him. Because, you see, it would not have been graceful to do, but I mean, I was not afraid of him. I was surprised the way he was criticizing Mari. He himself was such a wrong person. So I reached the conclusion that those who criticize a good leader, there's something wrong with it. And I sent a circular all over saying that no leader should be criticized. Do not try to find faults with a leader. I can look after the leader myself. And you better look after yourselves. So I wanted to find out why there is so much criticism of the leaders in France. Nowhere it happened like that. Maybe that, you see, you had a revolution, French Revolution, and the king and queen you criticized so much, and you got your freedom so-called from the queen. Maybe that is one of the basic historical reasons might be. So to criticize somebody is a sort of a historical upbringing. But even then, I would say French were wrong, because Marie Antoinette, whatever she did as a queen. And in Russia, I went, even the Tsars did the same. In every country where the queen and the king lived, they did the same. But she was very creative. If you see to the good points of her, you must try to see her good points. She was an extremely creative person. She gave so much work to the artists. She gave them so many ideas. She made beautiful furniture. She decorated her palaces with such beautiful things. She actually gave a complete vent to the Renaissance development in your country. I mean, when I went to see her palace, everybody told me, oh, have you seen her palace? I mean, there's nothing else to show but her palace to people nowadays. I mean, that's what she's done the job. When I went to see, I saw the greatness of this lady. And I'm sure some must have deceived her, and people criticized her for nothing at all. I just don't understand what was there to criticize. That was the pattern of those days. Every king and queen did the same as she did. She didn't do anything worse. She didn't kill anybody. She didn't do anything very bad. And if you see, say, the kings of England, horrible kings and queens, Bloody Mary, and then there is, we have got this one man who marries 7 wives, kills them. Horrible things they have done.
For example?
And still the royalty is on. Even now the ladies make their hairdressers like this, Princess Diana and all that. All over the world. They go as king and queen, and the British have put their king and queen at a very great height. You see, wherever they go, such a little country like that, you see, people call it ex-Great Britain. But still, how much they are propagating. And English are very proud. They would never criticize their authority of a leader. Never. While the leader was, Gavin had a mad wife, and quite a problem he had. I could see it, but nobody would say a word. If I said, say, they would keep quiet. And that's how today you find Sahaj Yoga, he spread so well. So one has to remember that this is not politics. This is not some king and queen ruling you. Sahaj Yoga is a very different thing. It is your mother loves you very much, and she wants you to rise higher and higher to enter into the kingdom of God. You know what French life is, where your children are going to go, what's going to happen to them. Think of it. It's hell here. Was hell once I came here. Nobody's wife is safe, nobody's husband is safe, everybody trying to break the family system, so many divorces coming up, everybody getting drunk and addicted to drugs and all kinds of things. Now AIDS coming from America. Everything is surrounding us. We are in a very big mess. We have to save our children. We have to save ourselves. And we have to become pure. But with our own understanding about life, whatever they have tried has failed. You can see it around. People now believe in anarchy. So when God's kingdom has to come on this earth, we must understand the nature of Sahaj Yoga. When you come to Sahaj Yoga, you are coming into the temple of God. All the deities want to welcome you. they want to look after. They want to give all the blessings. And they want you to give those powers by which you can give realization to others and improve their lives. Now, I know that maybe this historical factor or whatever it is.
Yes.
Or maybe the style of the media is the way the politics is in every democratic country. We always judge others. Now the ultimate judgment that is before us is the judgment of God Almighty. We have to judge ourselves. In the Quran it is written, your hand will give the witness against you. It will give witness against you at the time of Qiyamah, meaning the resurrection. So that is this time. You allow your hands to speak and they'll tell you what's wrong with you. Allow your feet to speak and they'll tell you what's wrong with you. You become like a mirror, you can see yourself clearly what you are, and you can also cure yourself, correct yourself, cleanse yourself, because you've got the power to do it. You are such powerful people. You are such powerful people. But this power cannot come to you if you challenge the authority of your leaders. I have given them the authority, and if you challenge them, you are challenging me directly. Moreover, how can I help you individually? You have to help yourself, and your leader has to help you. Supposing you go to a university and you have to learn something from your professor, and as soon as you see the professor, you start criticizing his suit or his nose.
You
don't also understand the joke. So, that is not a sign of intelligence, of pure intelligence. It's a sign of ego. And ego makes a person stupid. Is a nice story written about this in the Ramayana by Valmiki.
Valmiki.
Narada once got into the realm of ego, and he started saying that, what do I care for anyone? I am such a great celibate person. I have never married. Even Shiva had to marry. He married. I have never married. I am such a great brahmachari. And when he was walking on the road, he met two people who were sent by Sri Krishna to befool him. When Vishnu had sent him to befool this fellow, his ego. So these two persons came and started telling him, you are such a handsome man, you are such a great person, greater than Shiva, greater than any of the gods. So he became greater stupid fool. His ego, if it swells up like this, start floating in the air. It's like a plastic. You can't see the reality. You think no end of yourself, oh, I'm so great. But that's not reality. Now this fellow believed that he was the most handsome man going. Then they said, we have come to tell you that there is a beautiful woman, she is the princess, and her Swayamvara is going to be performed, for which you are the most suitable man. Because she says she will marry the most handsome and the most intelligent, and you are the most intelligent and the most handsome man. So he said, where is the wedding? He said, in Maya Nagari.
In
Maya Nagari actually means a city of illusion. So they took him there, and he saw a big pendal and every arrangement made, big music was on and all that, and then they all sat in line, you see, waiting for the princess to come in. So the princess came out with her garland, and she went round, and she was, very shy. And when she faced Narada, she just laughed. She forgot everything, laughed aloud. Not only giggled, but laughed. And then she went ahead. So he asked them, what's the matter? They said, we don't know. She might come back, let us wait. She must have been very happy to see such a handsome man. But she never came back. So they went to the, they went out, and he said, now let me go and now rest for a while. So he wanted to wash his face in the lake. When he looked into the water, he was amazed, he was looking like a monkey. So he got very angry with these two persons, and he said, why did you befool me like this? They said, sir, we did not befool you. It's your ego which makes you out into a stupid personality. You were sitting there and criticizing everybody, saying he's ugly looking, he's useless, he's good for nothing. You were the one looking like a monkey. And you were such a stupid fool, even when we told you this is Maya Nagari, you did not think that Maya Nagari is just an illusion. So you lived in an illusion about yourself. And there was no princess, there was nothing of the kind. Only your illusion created all those things. So this is what ego is. And this ego cannot give you anything but illusion and stupidity. Now, this has to be understood very clearly, that you have to be prepared to face yourself. You are people, if you are really French and if you really love your country and your countrymen, you have to become something special. Those people who are getting drowned, if you have to save them, you must know how to swim. So, I have to tell you that please try to understand that whatever your leader has to say to you, you have to listen and you have to work it out. Now, it happened once in Switzerland. There was one English girl married to a Swiss. She was a boot, absolute boot. And she started telling people against Arno. And they formed a big majority. They all signed and sent me all the complaints against Arno. And then their leader telephoned to me. So they said, Mother, please ask Arno to resign. Otherwise, we all will resign, threatening me. I said, you better all resign, I will have Arno. And they were shocked. I said that if I have made Arno the leader, I must have seen something in that person. And things changed. So this is one thing, because when I tell anything to Patrick, he says, Mother, I'll tell, but I don't know. He is not so sure that you will listen to me. I could read that very clearly. You like or not other leaders. He doesn't talk like that. And I feel very sorry. And as you know, I play tricks. And yesterday I played a trick on him. When he told me that some ladies used to fight and he gave them to make a nice, what you call, split for me. In that creativity they became very friendly. So I said it openly. That's my trick. And I said that's the trick of a leader, to see if he's going to be criticized. And I knew that he was criticized. Didn't like that he told me this. He is there to tell me about you. He has to report to me. But if you have faith in my love, you should not doubt anything. Now, we are here to judge ourselves and not to judge others. I know the French are very individualistic. But all the individuals now have to enter into my being. We have to all become part and parcel of the Virat. The microcosm has to become the macrocosm. For that, you have to give up your small, limited personality. You have to become very large, big. But what do you have to surrender is your ego. That's the stupid thing which covers you up completely in the head here. And doesn't allow you to grow. So, if you fight with it, it will exhaust you. For example, your ego is here and you are here. So light falls and you fight with your own image or your shadow. When you are exhausted, then you say, Mother, I've been fighting with my ego, but the ego doesn't go. It's an illusion. The thing is to stand under the light, of enlightenment. No shadow. You don't fight yourself. So you don't fight your ego. You must only know that it exists. You stand before the mirror and say, now, how do you do, Mr. Ego? Now a stupid idea comes, you say, oh, Mr. Ego, now don't tell me anything, I know, it's all right, it's all right. So you start detaching yourself. Like we say, all right, I forgive, I forgive, I forgive. I forgive you, you get out, you get out. Best thing is to shoe beat yourself. Then this ego business goes away. Now any idea comes into your head that this is very wrong, it should not have happened. You say, oh no, forget it. Like you see, supposing I see anything black on my sari, I won't have it. Yes, I'll wash it off. Supposing I think this my sari is me and this whatever is dirt on that is also me. Then I won't give it up. But ego is even worse than dirt and filth. Because it attacks others. Also it attacks you. It comes from overactivity of the brain. First thing is attacked is your liver, by which you sometimes get bilious, you don't feel like eating food, you go on throwing food, you become very fussy, you don't like this, the Ganpati should not be kept like that, should be kept like that, your attention becomes all the time mad. Especially food, you don't like English food, you don't like Indian food, you don't like Russian food, you just like French food, and then you don't even like French food. Then you go to somebody, oh, I didn't like that, was very bad, this is not having there, this carpet was very bad, that one was not all right, this one was not all right. Like that you don't like anything. You have no taste but left in your mind. Don't like anything, how can you enjoy anything? It's like a tongue which has no taste but, you see, doesn't like anything. And such a waste of energy, I tell you.
Yes, sir.
Same with dress, I don't like this. I don't like that, you'll get to 10 stores, you won't like this, you won't like that, you won't like that. Then you'll be exhausted and then you'll buy something stupid, a hippie thing and come out with all your hair standing on the... Absolutely exhausted, I saw today one. Hairdressing, you will go to the hairdresser, he'll be fed up, he'll just shave you off. Your attention becomes extremely disturbed. Today we went to the stores. I was talking, to him, but looking at another thing, moving them. I'm talking to you, looking here, there, there. And the person to whom I'm talking also looking all over. And the attention becomes so funny that you tell them something, they do another thing. Like in America, you ask him, what's your name? Simple question. That person looking somewhere else. Then say, did you say, what's my name? Then we look at another thing. I'll say, yes, I just wanted to know your name. So, then he'll turn another. Did you ask for my name? We'll go on for 5 minutes, then I will say, all right, I don't ask you anything, I'm sorry. You tell them something. A French lady came to me criticizing all the people here, just to see me. She just forced into my house, came to me and all that. I made her sit down. She was quite a big ego and all that. I gave her kumkum and I said, in the night you put it here. Telephones to me. Next day she telephones to me, kumkum is very sour. I said, what are you doing? I'm eating. I didn't understand English, she said. But I said, I applied it here. Didn't you also see my action? Or I put it in your mouth. I said, don't eat kumkum. Then she asked, did you say I should not eat kumkum? She's a very famous woman. Oh, very big people are fond of her, this, that. I don't know what sort of woman she is and what's wrong with her. I just don't understand. But not only that, attention gets like that. they don't have proper memories left. They'll come and stand before and say, "Where is Mataji? I'm standing there. Such a big woman.
Yes, that's
where is Mataji?" I said, "Get a microscope now." The eyes become upside down. Now, the attention part is all right. Now, forget about the attention. Physically, what happens? You vomit every food you eat. You become thin like a TB patient. There are so many like that. All their, what you call, cheeks gone like that. What you see in your shops, you see, they have made models out of these mad people there. And they look so old at a young age. You see, there was a lady who was traveling with me in a train. She was a French lady. That's quite thin, you see, and like that. So I thought she's the old lady, naturally. So we had a seat. So I said, "I'll sleep on here, you better sleep down." In the morning, she said, "Thank you very much," and all that. I said, "No, no, after all, you see, I must respect your age and this and that." "Yes, yes, yes, you know." So I said, "What's your age?" She says, "My age is 40 years." I said, "Okay." That's my daughter's age. What did I do with this woman? All gone like that, all wrinkles, ear wrinkles. I thought I am older, younger than her. So I went up and she slept. She said, 40 years. I said, "Really, I can't be." You told the whole story? I must say, the Italian is better than English. Because put it in proper clarity, you fancy language. All right. So now, this is what happens to a person. See, such a person gets old very soon. He is such a bore. Nobody likes such a company. He may not like anyone, but such a bore no one likes. Now, the physical side of it, that you may develop an ego by which you might get diabetes. Then you might get high blood pressure. Yes, high blood pressure. Your kidney can stop working. You can get blood cancer. You become vulnerable to any cancer. Or your heart, you will get heart attack. You might get palpitations. You might get asthma. You might get cirrhosis. You might get on your hands and all that, all kinds of eczema. You might also ultimately end up in a state, as you call it, gaga state.
So the old people who don't know what they say.
Nowadays, in young age. Now a disease, which I say is going to come, has already started. I was told about that. That your conscious mind becomes selfless. That is, you can move your hand if you are unconscious about it. But consciously, if you want to move your hand, you cannot.
Control it.
You get paralyzed. With these things happening, I don't know what other things can happen. One can develop eye problem. You cannot face the sun. And your nose and ears can get absolutely all the time sneezing, and because the phlegm melts away, so nose starts, sort of all the time it's flowing. And from your ears also, you might get pus will start coming out of it. Now, that's the blessings of Western East. So be careful. To correct your ego, first thing, you should never criticize others. Never get irritated with others. French are known to be very irritable. Once I came by my car, which has a right-hand drive. and Dr. Spiro driving it. And it always used to go on the right-hand side. Even the slightest movement, the back, back, poop, poppy, everything going on, all the
time.
And they become very impatient. So try to patience. Now, be patient. You are a surgeon. Be patient. Be patient. But for the ladies, it is even worse. In my experience, I have seen when women try to dominate. Actually, a woman is like this Mother Earth. And if the Mother Earth thinks that these trees are dominating her, then what should we say? Anyway, if the women think that the husbands are dominating, I must say they are very wrong. Now, it's very easy to handle husbands. Mine is there. But if you are not wise and stupid, you think by dominating, saying things, bad things, you can manage him, you cannot. But to handle your husband is important that you should show that you are very submissive. And it's nice to be submissive that way.
It's interesting,
I'm sure. You see, because men are very simple, they have no angularity. Women have angularity. Because they don't live together. See, men live together, so they have no angularity. So you must know that all of them have the general trend. First of all, they must see their watch. They'll take you to the airport 1 hour earlier. Without getting ready, they'll be saying, now, 5 minutes left, 6 minutes left, like that. They keep the time. Very common. Now, there's a trick. These also, boys do that to me. Once, you know, Warren, Horridge, he was, always used to take me to the airport at least 2 hours earlier. Because aeroplane and airport, you see, the men become mad like that. Aeroplane, going by to the airport means men are all mad. I mean, supposing you miss the plane. You miss the plane, that's all. You can have a nice meal there, you can talk to people, there could be some new people you might meet, something good might happen, nothing of the kind. Aeroplane means must run. But even they have become surgeries, this is a bad habit they have. So, I told Warren, see now, don't hurry me. Now this time I'm going when I have to go. To go early. So 1 hour before he took all the luggage, everything, got into the new car, sat on it with somebody else and all of them drove off. I'm a housewife, I had to do lots of things in the house and I still did it. After 1 hour, I sat on a much older car, which was an older car, and Dr. Spiro was driving and he said, I'm enjoying now, Mother, it's so nice, it drives so slowly, I can see the nice scenery. I said, very good. We reached the airport, there was no Warren, no luggage. There were two surgeons waiting, they said he called us 1 hour earlier, we are waiting here for 1 hour. After 20 minutes, we find Sri Warren and company coming. How are you here? I said, why? I am here. What about you? Which way did you come? I said, the same way. I saw the way. But he said, I never saw your car. I said, I disappeared in the thin air and crossed over your car and jumped over and came here. He said, Mother, you did some tricks to me, I must say. You must have given a bandhan. I said, no, nothing. I just... What you have to do when your husband is hurrying you up, just give him a bandhan. Finish. For Sahajyoginis, it's very easy. Give a bandhan to the husband, no problem. There's no need to dominate. Because you have Mahalakshmis, you have Shaktis, and all the deities are going to help you first before they help your husband. But the condition is that you have to be a Grahalakshmi first of all. You must have all the qualities of a Grahalakshmi. If you are a dominating woman, finds faults with everyone, then you are not a Grahalakshmi at all. Especially the leaders' wives are like that sometimes, I see. I'm sorry. They are much more dominating and much more criticizing. Even no leader can do that. And they live in a fool's paradise. They are not leaders. but a fool's paradise, thinking they are the, what you call, the whole soul of the room. These stupid women must come round and behave themselves, I'm telling you, because I've known such women become schizophrenic, because they live in imaginary world, not leaders, and they have no business to behave like that. The wives of the leaders have to look after everyone, to be kind to them, and they should stand in between the leader and others. So that if the leader is supposing angry, he should say, now it's all right, forgive, forgive, like that. That is the duty of a leader's wife. Try to pacify, see. That is her job, not to criticize others.
Les autres.
On the whole, a lady should never be right-sided, because there are so many problems, she will jump in. Seen these things happening in Sahaja Yoga. There was a girl who was very right-sided. And she, her husband became important. Then I told her, you better become all right. So she tried to be all right, so she had a child. But the child was born like a devil. Then the right-sided woman might have abortions. First she will not conceive. Even if she conceives, she'll have abortions. Now, if she does not have abortions, and even if she has children, still the right-sided women will create children who will be devilish. They'll be spoiled children, will dominate other children. Now, if you see why in the West there is so much of violence, I would blame the mothers. The mothers, instead of giving love to their children, try to dominate.
Oh dear.
You must discipline your child, but with love, and should not be a dominating person to the husband and the rest of the family, because then the child picks up. Then the children cannot be changed easily. Always right-sided children may have also physical deficiencies. Right-sided mothers, children, might have blood cancer, born with a blood cancer, could be born with a bad liver, all these deficiencies. And also could be, say, born with physical handicaps. What you call the apostate children. So when people say, what's wrong? Everything is wrong. Your pregnant woman should never see the eclipse of the sun or the moon. Because if they see the sun eclipse, they'll have physical problems. The children will be born with hands like these, feet like that. And if they see the lunar eclipse, the moon's eclipse, then they will have mental problems. So they should not spoil their children at all. But they should not also over-discipline their children or shout at husbands and shout at children. They should develop a very mild, beautiful, congenial personality. I have two daughters. One is 40 years, one is 38 years. All these lives, I have given two slaps to the younger one, very small, and once to the elder, that's all. And they are very well behaved, and even now, if I say no to something, means no. Once my younger daughter, when she joined college, she said, should I wear sleeveless blouses? So I said, all right, go ahead. So she said, why don't you wear? I said, because, see, I feel shy. Why should I expose my body, first of all? And secondly, that there are chakras, which are important, they must be covered. So she said, then it is no criteria. Why should you have said, do what you like? You should have told me that just don't do it. And she was about 18 years of age, not small girl. The another girl, when she was, you see, in India also they started with teenage. We don't have teenage in India. But, I mean, there is a continuous life, isn't it? But they call it teenage. See, certain age is teenage. And they wanted to start a magazine. And they came and interviewed her and asked her, they said, you go away. And we'll ask her. She was only 30. They said, you have boyfriends? She said, no, why should I have? I have lots of girlfriends, and my cousins are there, And we are very happy with that. I don't want to trust somebody who is not known to me. So they said, did your mother tell you not to talk to boys? So she said, no, I can understand myself. My mother always, if she tells me, there's no need to tell her, but if she tells me, she's for my good, she tells me. Yeah. The last question they asked her, they said, but don't you feel like flying in the air like a bird? Wisdom. So what she says? She says, but let me grow my wings first. And this they published and said that she was the youngest among all the teenagers and was the wisest. So what I am saying, you shouldn't spoil your children, but you shouldn't also dominate the children and your husband and the family. It's not a good thing for women at all. It's not very sweet also. You won't go to a house where one is standing with a broom in her hand, you see. Run away. No one likes. Our attention should be on our spirit, onto higher things. Not how you keep your spoon, how you keep your fork, what the, no, higher things. All the time, attention should be on our spirit. Because we have to grow. Your vibrations on photograph in the rooms. Don't judge others' vibrations. And don't be harsh to others. It doesn't behove a Sahaja Yogi to talk harshly to each other. Doesn't behove. Leave alone meanness, selfishness, miserliness. It should be a character. We should show as if there's light in that person. The meanness, talking at the back, murmuring souls, as Christ says, criticizing others, that danger to you and to Sahaja. Meditate every day. Be in thoughtless awareness. Any thought comes, you say, forgive. And grow. Unless and until you are matured in Sahaja Yoga, you cannot really enjoy the taste of the bliss of God. So I congratulate you people that you got so many people in Sahaja Yoga. Now see that they all settle down properly. Achieve what they are here for. And good news is that you are all invited to India. Now the first chance is to be given to French this time. And be careful, because they always have bad livers. So, we'll make all arrangements that you don't suffer from it. We'll see to it that we'll give you all that is necessary to keep the liver cool and nice. But come with the idea that you have to enter into the subtleties of that country where lots of saints have lived and feel the vibrations, and not there to criticize, oh, this telephone is bad, car is bad, food is bad. You can't help. You come with the idea of enjoy. Otherwise, you spend so much money and what comes out of it is nothing but frustration, anger, temper, pursuits. Also those who want to get married and engaged should give your details to the leaders here, truthfully.
Yes.
And should tell truthfully if you want to marry outside or not, everything truthfully. There should be no hypocrisy. In Sahaja Yoga, there should be no hypocrisy. If you have already a boyfriend or what, everything should be written clearly, so I will know that this is the kind of a person you are. In India, nobody below the age of 18, a girl, and below the age of 21, a boy, can be married. We can engage them. All right. And those who want to marry cannot go to India and get married. Also, we'll arrange something for them. Don't stick on with people who are negative. Stick on with the people who are positive, talking positively about Sahaja Yoga. Always I find, as soon as I see, I find one negative person walking to another negative person. Sitting together, they become friends. Everybody who is trying to form a group like Madame Defarge, you see, she was sitting and was forming a group of people to fight. Such people we don't want in such. Anybody who tries such things, which I have nothing to do with it, I have had enough of it. I want to enter into the kingdom of God. Just one positive lecture. Also, those who have got liver problems should take a treatment. It's very simple, for 1 month, in summertime, is the best. Anything else? If you have any personal problem, anything, you must try one thing first of all, is to write the problem, put it in front of my photograph, and say, Mother, you look after this problem. If it is not solved, then you can tell your reason in fault. There are certain things which you may feel a little different. But you shouldn't get a shock. Like in Sahaja Yoga, we have to respect our chastity. Women have to respect and men have to respect. Because our Ganesha has to be all right. Those who have come to Sahaja Yoga will be amazed. After coming to Sahaja Yoga, nobody has got AIDS. In India, which is such a large country, they found only one woman having AIDS. Then they went very thoroughly into it. They got only 12 people who have got AIDS. They too have contamination from people. So this Ganesha has to be strong within us. Also, like, it's not inhibition like in the Catholic Church. Sex is no sin in surgery. But the same sex with your wife, with faithful relationship. So it is neither Freud nor Catholic Church.
How long every day should we meditate not to make any mistake or going on ego or superego?
That's one thing you take out of your mind. You can never make mistakes. Your Kundalini doesn't make any mistakes. It is not what time. You see, it is just if you sit before the photograph and you are getting cool breeze, say about take the cool breeze for about 2 minutes, say namaskar, finished. There is no ritual about Sahaja Yoga. Like some people say, I've not washed my hands, I've not had my bath, how will I put my hands to Mother? She's your mother. You can put your hands to me anytime. But you have to respect.
For instance, if we didn't have respect for you before realization.
Doesn't matter. No, doesn't matter. Mother is very forgiving, isn't she? She's the source of all forgiveness. Even after realization, don't have respect for the timing it's all that. Till you have not known me, ignorance is not to be punished. But after knowing me, after seeing the photographs of lights and everything, after giving realization to few people, if you start misbehaving, then I can't help it. It's like this, you are climbing a mountain, slowly, slowly. When in the beginning, if you fall, doesn't matter, you can again climb. But you go higher, and then you fall very fast. So your attention should be always at higher. And doubting should be less about yourself and about Sahaja Yoga, because you have to learn so many things. So many things people start doubting, like you say, for the puja. Why this puja? Why? What is the need? Why to worship this lady? She is like us. But why these people are so anxious to do the puja? Why do they come miles together to do the puja? What is there? What do they get? When you suddenly jump. I am the person who suffers. And if somebody says puja, oh God, I say, now look, it doesn't matter, all right, we have it. Now, in the puja, they give some money. That improves your nabhi chakra. But I don't take the money. Found out a solution. Whatever money you give me, I write it down. And in addition to that, I put my own money. And buy silver for your pujas. which I give to all the ashrams. Of course, that's my property, you see, as far as the deities are concerned, my supposed. Before that. And so, because first formerly people used to use plastic, you see, to give me kumkum in a plastic. And that's not auspicious. I'm not happy, they won't emit vibration, big problem. That way they are French in a way. And the French don't like it very much either. So, these questions are to be asked. In the beginning people do feel that way. But actually I don't need any money, and neither you cannot give me anything. Even if you want to give me something, I may take it, but I return it in a big way. And my husband doesn't mind it. And in a big way, in a big way. You can find out from them in every ashram what things I've given them. You can tell yourself.
Yeah. Well, so many things, Srimad, as you gave us.
Thank you. So yeah, that is. This is not a money-making proposition. I am not interested in money. And you shouldn't think of those little speck stuff. In the beginning, of course, you can't understand somebody. But later on also, if you don't understand, then you cannot do surgery because you are petty-minded. And even if something is so obvious and you don't want to see it, that means you are blind. So what's the use of telling about some beautiful colors to a blind person? So first try to understand your leaders. Try to understand what they are telling you, try to become sensitive and try to enjoy, and then I won't have to tell you anything. Also you can test your power. You see, when you give vibrations to somebody, does he get realization or not? Or somebody who is sick, you put your hand and see, does he feel all right or not? Now supposing you give me French money and I don't use it at all, then how will I know its value? Now if I say that you've got the power and you don't use it, then how will you know if you've got power or not? Use your power on trees, on flowers, anything, you'll be surprised that it makes a difference to them. All right? So next time I'm going to see lots of French more brought in by you for your friends, your relations. Tell them that this is the greatest thing that they should have. We give them alcohol, then we give them dinners. Instead of that, give them the alcohol that is eternal. Because when you take this, then it never comes down. You are there all the time.
There's a problem. Since he was 3 months old, he could not drink any milk. So even in the Amrut there is milk.
And, in what?
In Amrut there is
did
milk.
You drink that?
Yeah,
nothing happened?
Mais je sais pas comment ça s'est passé, il est tombé tout son pantalon sur le carré.
He was trying to drink it yesterday, but he doesn't know what happened. He fell on his trousers. He could not drink.
He should have taken. But he can take now, vibrated water. After some time, he'll get over all your allergies, you can get over. All right, now I think we should give some time to the other people. Are you all satisfied? And alcohol, I must tell you about alcohol, one point. They always come out with price, saying that price created wine in the wedding. Of course now, you see, the main thing is I have to explain all of them because there's no difference between me and them. But it always happens that when a person lives, like Christ lived, nobody believed him. And when he died, we have so many Christians now. So now I'm living, better listen to me. Be wiser than others. Now, Christ didn't make an alcohol. What he made was the juice of the grapes, which is called also wine in Hebrew. The answer is, it was made in a short time, you see, just like that. And alcohol has to be rotten, so it takes time, all right? So like this, many such things will come. You are Christians, you will compare with me with Christ. If you are Islam, Muslim, you will compare with me, Muhammad Sahib. If you are Hindu, you will compare me with Krishna. Like they said, but Krishna never did raising of the Kundalini. But I would say like this, that was not his job. whatever is my job, I'm doing it. Like that, it goes on and on and on. So you shouldn't worry about all those things. First of all, you become a realized soul, you will understand everything, you will reach the state of doubtless awareness. So only aim should be that we should achieve that state. That is it. And whatever is needed has to be done. All right, may God bless you. How can we meet the other austeres? But the reason was like this, very simple reason, that we wanted to make a place like a hotel, because that place is, that area, according to Guido, is very rare now, and people won't be allowed to build anything there. So I just thought best is to make some proper place. Supposing if that place becomes very expensive, we should be able to sell out these. So I said, make like a hotel. If we can sell that out and if we can achieve the price of the land also, then we can use that money anywhere. So from that point of view, I've changed. All right? But now for that, the money we have to collect. And those who are not going to India must donate at least £100 per year, so that we can start this project here in Rome, where our children are to be educated. And also we can start later on other projects like this, wherever we have to. So it's not much in 1 year to collect. People can give £100. And those who can afford to do it, or can be also £50, those who can afford. So £50 to £100 is not much per year. And all this money has to be sent to Arnu, and we please ask Arnu to start a new account. So the money is with him, and whenever you need anything, we'll try to send. I want to make a complete idea as to what is needed, how much is needed. And we should work more on barter system. Like, we can send very nice timber, say from England. And Austrian timber also, he was saying there's some lady whose father wants to sell. Mm-hmm. But first to verify, what is the price, the cubic feet, because in London it's very, very cheap, especially for these, all this, that's very cheap in London. Maybe there is some wood that, did they tell you that this is for show, very good wood they have bought, cedar or something?
No.
Oak, very good old oak they have bought, which you can use for making something. So, in any case, somebody can go from Italy and have a look at it, yes. What things they have, note it down, and what we can send. They'll be sending you pine for other things, roof and all that. So that you will know how much you need, what you need, more than they send. So this has to be first started by Italians themselves. See, they should try to give 100.
All of course.
Italians have to start it. And then others can do also. Indians cannot send you money because that money is not working out. But they can send you chandeliers, they can send you, say, other things like brass things. Also, they might send you, I mean, if you think it proper, is another thing what we call as the furnishing. You can send it that. You see, the next important thing one has to do is to pay attention to that.
Also, being a collective project, it has great value.
Going to be wonderful. That would be the first beginning of a proper ashram, because we have got Shuddhi Camp, no doubt, but Shuddhi Camp has given a lot of troubles. And actually, I had to put in a lot of money in that to begin with. But here it starts in a very nice way and it's over. Now, regarding Milano, everything is all right. Working out all right.
Now we have an ashram in Sicily.
Huh?
We have a new ashram in Sicily.
Sicily? Right. Milano also has a very good ashram.
Yes, beautiful.
So much of debt is there. What else?
Any
question?
Thank you very much. No more.
No question. You all have reached the state of thoughtless awareness, doubtless awareness. I am sure French will come around also. All right. So what about you, having some children?
I will.
You must have some dead children also. Don't have any. Now, those people who have been with Alexander, are they still here?
Yes.
Please raise your hands. I would like to see.
Ceux qui datent de l'époque d'Alexandre.
15-20 chemin de chien.
About 15. About 15-20.
I have to warn people. I must warn. She had a very bad effect on all of you. And it was a very person with great inertia. And I've seen that such a person, if that comes, even may not be as a leader, otherwise, and has a relationship with someone, then such a person doesn't go much in the search. So you have to make a deliberate effort, meet him with shoes every day, and just don't think of him, because you have to progress further. The first effect will be that those who are newcomers will see you and run away. Because they'll find out a little traits will be there of Alexander. So it is important that you become an example for the newcomers because you have been old Sahajogis. Now, you remember Christ has said, first will be last. So any one of you thinks that I am the first who came to Sahajoga, I am the person who got realization first, I have been with mother for so many years, must know there's a puzzle on that. Whenever somebody tells me, I was the first mother I came to, I was the first at the airport, I was first like this, and there's a saying like this, I'll tell you what I say, read this. Who says first? So I tell him that you are first of the first is first of you. Second and third are 0-2. First of the last is last of you. First of the last is the last of you. Please tell me what are you. First of the first. What is the first of first? You none of you have been guessed?
The first of the first is just the first.
No, F.
Okay.
All right?
Yes.
Second and third are 0-2. And first of the last. He's first of you.
Okay.
Last of you.
F-O-O-L.
So those who said first, I was the first. I was the first. All right. So, first of the first.
Quel est le premier? Celui qui dit être le premier est un
idiot.
Like I reach at an airport, fellow customer. I came first to the airport. I was the first to see you. I was the first to garland you. All right. And I was the first to talk to you. So I would say I was the last to see you. So this kind of idea is very strong. How far are you in your realization? How far are you in your collectivity is the point. Hear my point? How much you enjoy collective living? Now, for example, this place, there are very few people who want to stay in together because French cannot live together, come on. But Austrians want to stay together. Now, look at that. French The first of the first F is there. It can mean fine, it can mean, what else? Fantastic. So first I came to France. That's the first country I lived from it. And the first leader that you had was Marie. She was one of the seven first I had broke my neck. Now, so with all that first, with all that first, be careful. Though Austria starts with A, they are one of the last. But they are
in letters, they are the last.
They are doing so well. All have to remember that we have to be first in surgery, first in vibration, and topmost in collectivity. That's the sign. You should remember this. And try to beat that Alexander issue. Result, he may get a chance to come back. All right? And accept the newness of Surge Yoga in France. All right. Have you heard the program? Have you seen the program of my touring?
Yes, Shrimataji.
That suits you all right?
Very much, Shrimataji.
Now, Italians, have you seen the program?
Yes, Shrimataji.
Is all right?
Of course.
You are all right. Now, from Belgium, is there somebody else? But it's all right.
Yes.
You seen the American program?
Yes, Shrimataji.
It's all right. So, now I think anybody has any personal problem can talk to me separately. There's a little thing I have to tell you about that. And who else? What's he saying? What is it? What
are you saying? Five, six persons.
Want to see me?
Yes.
All right. So now, because we have only one room, the rest have to be.
Before going there, may we have your mantra before going to
that? Yes.
Comme il n'y a simplement que cette pièce, Shrimataji a demandé qu'après les gens qui n'ont pas de problème rentrent chez eux, de sorte à ce qu'on puisse parler avec les autres. Just have now our modest mantra, please.